Now, I'm sure that we can all agree with each other when I say that music holds such a deep, influential impact on our lives. I like music just as much as the other guy. Whether it's hip-hop, pop music, country, whatever music you listen to, those songs, that specific artist, those specific lyrics that artist is putting inside his music is resonating with you. Music speaks to the soul. It manipulates your mood. It puts you in a state of mind, whether it's a happy state of mind or a sad state of mind. You just have to really be conscious of how you feel when you listen to music, and you have to really be aware of what the music's actually doing to you. And this is a topic that I feel like a lot of people don't talk about, but I want to be the one to talk about it because this is something that I learned, and I learned it the hard way. Now, I want to tell you a quick little story. Back when I went through my first breakup, I used to be very depressed, and I used to listen to a lot of sad music. Songs such as Drake, Childish Gambino, Bryson Tiller, Frank Ocean, X, Trippy Red. I would listen to all these songs and artists and not realize what it was doing to me. It got bad to the point where I was spending up to 5 to 8 hours laying in bed crying about the breakup, crying about how bad I thought that I was. Little did I know, those songs was manipulating my mood. It was manipulating my energy. I was only praising my depression just by listening to those songs. But as soon as I put on a different song, I don't remember exactly what that song was. I believe it was a Pharrell Williams song. I got happy. Like, I felt better. I felt good about myself. And it totally changed the way I thought about things. It totally changed the way I felt about the whole situation. In that moment, I realized how much of an impact music actually has on you. More than you can realize. So before we get into how music actually affects you, I want to introduce to you guys two frequencies. One being 440 Hz and the other being 432 Hz. Now, I'm not going to get too much deep into these frequencies. You can do your own research. But based off my research, 440 Hz is a negative frequency and 432 Hz is a positive frequency. It's brighter. It's easier on the ears. It brings more mental clarity. Now, keep that in mind as we talk about this topic. You see, what a lot of people misunderstand is that music, it affects your mood. It makes you want to do certain things. For an example, if you were, let's say you were out in a bad neighborhood, right? And you were listening to Bob Marley. Would you feel the need to pull out a gun on somebody, hurt somebody, do a drive-by on somebody, do anything negative? No, because that specific song is putting you in a calm mind state. It's putting you in a happy vibration. It's putting you in a good mood. Now, if you were to go in the bad neighborhood and listen to, let's just say you're listening to G Herbo, of course you're going to want to do low vibrational things. Of course you want to hurt somebody, pull out a gun, do a drive-by, because those lyrics are ultimately being fed in your subconscious, and ultimately you want to do those things because that is what you're digesting, that is what you're taking in, and it's being planted in your subconscious. Here's the thing, a lot of you guys need to realize that your subconscious is a garden. There are spiritual seeds that you plant inside those garden, and they grow over time. So what you feed into your subconscious will ultimately be your reality. That's the problem that people misunderstand today. They don't realize that these lyrics that they're singing out loud are being fed into their subconscious. They don't realize that these lyrics are manifesting their own reality. I'll give you an example. Way back when, before I even know about frequencies and vibrations, before I even know about spirituality, I used to listen to a lot of A$AP Rocky. A lot of A$AP Rocky. A$AP Rocky was probably one of my favorite artists. This was back at a low time in life when I didn't have confidence. Me listening to A$AP Rocky gave me confidence. It made me feel like the shit. It made me feel like I had fashion. It made me feel like I was the man. I walked out with my chest out. I would go in school, you know, feeling like I was pretty. Because, you know, everybody that knows A$AP Rocky, he calls himself pretty. I would feel like I was the man, you know, I couldn't take shit from nobody. Because over time, what he was saying in his lyrics, I was digesting, I was taking in, and it was ultimately changing me as a person. You see, music changes you. This is why I want to talk about this, because it gets bad. It gets bad. It gets bad to the point where people are praising their depression. If you are depressed, if you are sad, if you feel like you're not going anywhere in life, if you feel like you have anxiety, you have self-confidence issues, you often think about committing suicide, listening to depressing music is praising your depression. It's not going to help you become happier. It's not going to help you change your ways. It's not going to help you get out that rut. It's only going to put you in a shittier and shittier mood. And I get it's easy. It's easy to lay in bed and just feel sad and feel bad for yourself. It's easy. I've done it plenty of times, but you need to realize that listening to that type of music, listening to depressing songs, listening to things that put you in a bad mood, it's only praising your depression. Because what you're doing is you're listening to those lyrics. You're listening to those lyrics about putting shots in your brain, killing yourself. Oh, I'm not worthy. I'm not good enough. Oh, I need to chase this girl. I miss my ex. Why did you leave me? You broke my heart. Listening to these lyrics are being fed into your subconscious. Do you see what I'm saying here? Do you see what I'm saying? These lyrics are being digested into your head, and now they're starting to become your reality because that's all you're hearing. That's all you're soaking up. It's like a rag. If you imagine your brain is a rag. Now you put that rag underwater, right? That rag is soaked. That water is those thoughts, those negative thoughts, those lyrics about wanting to be sad, those lyrics about depression. Until you squeeze the rag and soak all that negative energy out, you will always have a wet rag. Your brain will always be filled with negative thoughts because that's all you're listening to. This is why a lot of people say that music is spell casting, because it puts you in a state of mind where you don't even realize what the fuck you're feeling. You don't even realize what you're manifesting. Rappers and musicians talk about it all the time. I could pull up plenty of interviews of rappers talking about, yeah, back when I used to start in music, I used to say a lot of negative lyrics that manifested into my life, and I've never realized that those lyrics were actually affecting me until I looked back and realized it.
I listen to like a song that I did last year, and I'll be like, I'm in New York in a Rolls Royce. And then it'll be like 2 years later, I still haven't put the song out, but I'm really in a Rolls Royce in New York. So I'm like, what the fuck? So I had to learn like not to say stuff like, if I go to prison, I'ma still be, you know what I'm saying? Like, I had to learn how to back away from that type of stuff and gang banging because it's, and sometimes I forget. Sometimes it'd be in my old music. I'd be like, what the fuck?
Perfect example is Kodak Black. He has an interview out right now where he says, yeah, over time I started to realize that the shit that I was saying inside of my songs was starting to become true.
So you don't want to put certain things in the atmosphere because you feel like that might generate.
Yeah.
This ties back with speaking shit into existence.
Speaking shit into existence.
Speaking shit into existence.
Believer speaking shit in existence.
And I'm a firm believer of speaking things into existence.
Speaking shit to exist.
If you speak it out loud, if you speak it inside your music, if you speak it inside of a journal, if you write it down, it's going to become your reality. Because that's all you're soaking your subconscious with. Now, I'm not saying you can't listen to these types of songs. I'm not saying don't listen to hip hop. I'm not saying don't listen to music about killing people. I'm not saying that you shouldn't listen to music about depression, you know, feeling sad. But just know what it does to you. Because you and I both know you're not going to stop listening to those songs. But I just want you to realize what it's doing to you. Because while you're sitting up there screaming these lyrics, oh, I want to die. Oh, I want to chase that girl. Oh, I wish I had my ex back. Why did you leave me? You broke my heart. I'm so sad. I'm so depressed, I have anxiety. Bro, little did you know, you're only making it worse. So if you want to change your mood, if you want to change the way you think, if you want to get yourself out of that mental rut, why don't you start by listening to better music? Or at least realize what it's doing to you. This is why oftentimes you see people my age wanting to be a gangster, wanting to tote guns, wanting to trap, wanting to go out in the hood and do fuck shit, wanting to rob people, wanting to do drive-bys, wanting to indulge in negative activities, because all these songs that they're listening to is telling them to do that. So what are they gonna do? They're gonna do it. You know what I mean? So I wanted to talk about this because I feel like a lot of people just don't realize what music actually does to you. It's deeper than just lyrics, a beat, an instrumental, some hi-hats, some 808s, and that's it. It goes way deeper. You see, there's frequencies involved. There's manipulation tactics involved. There's spell casting involved. There's a lot of evil things that are involved in music. You just need to be conscious of what it's actually doing to you. Because if you don't realize what it's doing to you, you're going to find yourself acting like somebody you're not. At the end of the day, what we see with these two eyes is a projection of our consciousness. It's a projection of our subconscious mind. Our subconscious mind is constantly painting. It's constantly painting a reality. And whatever you feed your subconscious mind with, it's going to be painted onto the canvas. And that's what you're going to see. That's what's going to be projected through your eyes.